Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me give you some tips for selecting text on your Mac. So for a demonstration, I've got some sample text here inside of TextEdit, and we'll use this to show you how you can select different things. So you may know that you can click and drag to select. So for instance, I could start right here, click, and then drag and select as much text as I want. I can even drag backwards here and select text before the cursor. And that's kind of the standard way that most people select text. But there's so many different ways to do it, some of which are easier in different situations. So you can use a combination of your mouse or trackpad and the keyboard to select things. One way to do it is to click to put the cursor where you want the selection to begin. Go to where you want the selection to end and hold the shift key down and click again. So I'm holding the shift key down and I click and it selects everything between those two points. It's very easy and precise. It remembers that this is the starting point, and if I were to shift and click again, it would adjust the end point. So I can continue to adjust the end point as much as I want and the beginning point stays the same. Another thing you could do is you can click multiple times. So if I were to click once somewhere, it inserts the cursor and the word right there. If I were to click twice, it actually selects the word. So I can do a quick word selection by just double clicking on any word I want. If I were to click three times, it selects the entire line until the line return right here. So it's very easy to select the entire line. Now I can combine those two. If I were to double click on a word and then shift click somewhere else, it remembers that I'm selecting by word, not by character. So I can shift click right in the middle of this word, but it will select the entire word here at the end. Same with any other place I would click. It's going to do it by word instead of by character. If I were to triple click here, select the entire line, and then shift and click here, it's going to select the entire line, all the lines in between. It's not going to divide a line up. So you can see it's doing it by line now. Now here's something you may not know that you could do. You can select some text and then you can deselect text inside of it. Hold the shift and command key down and quickly drag. And you can see I've deselected this text in here. If I were to copy now and then paste, you can see I've pasted only the two parts that were selected and I'm missing that part that's in the middle here. This is tricky to do because usually when you select something, whether you're holding down the command or shift key or not, once you have a selection and you click inside of it and then you just pause for just half a second, you can see the cursor changes to an arrow and now you're moving. So it's very hard to actually shift click and then drag immediately and not hesitate over that first click. So now let's get away from using the mouse or trackpad at all. I'm going to leave the cursor right here and I'm going to move the cursor away so that I'm not using the mouse at all. I can of course use the arrow keys to move the cursor back and forth in the text, and I can hold the shift key down to select some in there. If I were to hold down the option key while doing it, it'll select by word. If I were to hold down the command key, it'll select to the end of the line or the beginning of the line. And likewise, I can continue to hold the shift key down and do things like down arrow for more lines below or go up above. Holding the option key down will do it by line. So you can do a lot with just using the arrow keys, the shift key to select, and then option and command key to further modify how far the cursor moves when you move the arrow. And here's one of the most useful selection shortcuts that someone like me uses all the time, but sometimes other users just don't know exists. If you go to Edit, you see that there's Select All, Command A. I use Command A all the time. Now, I wouldn't necessarily use it to delete or copy from this, but I would use it to style text, for instance, or to maybe copy everything from one document into another. So Command A is something that I constantly use. Not all of these tips work in all situations because some apps just don't make all these functions available to you. Like here's one that works in TextEdit, but not too many other places. You can use the Option key to change the cursor to a crosshair, and then you can select a rectangular space. And then you can do something with that. Like I'm going to copy here, then I'm going to select All, Delete, and Paste. And it's going to paste that rectangular selection in. Not particularly useful usually with text, but it is interesting.